Hello, reception.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
I know you can hear me, and I can hear you, but who are you? Why are you calling me?
I'm not calling you. You're calling Special Assignment.
Why?
I don't know why you're calling.
No, I haven't.
You haven't called? Okay, well, a call just came through to Skeen House Rosemount and I've answered it.
You think I'm ringing you, don't you?
I didn't call you. I have not called anybody.
I can't believe this. You've just called me. I've just picked up the telephone.
No, neither can I. I did not call you. I have not called anybody. I've just
picked up the telephone. You're obviously stupid, aren't you?
You are extremely rude. What is your name?
My name is David Maloney. And who are you?
David Maloney, and where are you calling from?
You've just called me. I've just picked up the telephone.
Where are you calling from?
You've called me.
Where are you
at
right now? Okay, where are you situated? Are you in Aberdeen? Where are you?
I'm living in the Lake District in the United Kingdom.
Okay, I did not call anybody. The last call I have used is to a taxi company to book a taxi for a guest. I have not called anybody.
What?
I have not called you. Your telephone line must be strange. It's not me that's calling you.
No. I have not made a telephone call. What's your number? We've got problems here. I've had a series of strange phone calls today. Can I have your telephone number, please?
No, I'd like your telephone number first so I can investigate it.
No. I'm getting telephone calls, basically, from various places in the world, okay?
If you give me your telephone number, I can investigate it with my manager.
Is something wrong with the telephone system?
It must be your telephone system, because I have not made any calls this evening.
No, it's not, no.
Well, it's not our telephone system either.
Whereabouts are you?
I'm in Aberdeen.
This is Windermere.
No, this is not Windermere. This is Aberdeen I'm calling from.
I've just picked up my telephone. You're ringing me. This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere.
I'm not in Windermere. I'm in Aberdeen.
Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
Tell me what you're saying to me. Listen to me first. I did not call you. I work for a hotel in Aberdeen. I did not pick up the call. I did not pick up the phone and phone your number.
I'm not going to apologise to you. It is not my fault. I have not dialed your number. I have no idea who you are, and I don't want to speak to you.
Well, that's fine. I will report it to the police because you gave me your name. Thank you very much. Goodbye. Good evening, Skeen House Rosemount.
Please call the police. Yes, I am not calling you. Don't you understand? There's a problem with the phones. I have no idea what it is. I have not called you.
Hello, reception.
God, not again. You are obviously stupid, aren't you?
I am not stupid. You are stupid because I have not called you.
Do you understand the fact I've told you on numerous occasions I have not called you?
And I have not called you.
I know it's not amusing. I've had the same problem with America. What do you want me to do?
Do you want me to call the police? What do you want me to do?
Please call the police.
Well, I have your name. You gave me your name already. You're calling me. I will easily call the police.
What? No, I'm not calling. You're calling me.
I am not calling you.
Well, I'm sorry, but I've just picked up the telephone. I have no idea who you are. I have just picked up the telephone to answer a call.
And where are you calling from? Where are you situated just now?
I'm living in the Lake District in the United Kingdom.
Okay, well, I have not called the Lake District, so...
Whereabouts are you?
I have not called your number.
Whereabouts?
I told you I'm in Aberdeen. I'm not telling you whereabouts I work.
I've had the phone ring here. I found that the people at the other end thought that I was calling them.
Well, you must have a wrong number.
I have no idea why.
Okay, well, that's not my problem.
You know, I'm sorry, but it's not my problem. It's not my fault. It's irritating to me. I've tried to contact the telephone companies about all this.
I will give you my telephone number.
Hello?
How are you?
Hello, Hotscars.
Hello?
Hello, Hotscars.
Skeen House Rosemount. Hello?
Hello, yes.
Hello, hiya. How can I help?
Hotscars, you want to book a cab?
Sorry?
You want to book a cab? You just rang me.
I did not just ring you.
Yes, you did.
I did not just ring you.
I just received your call. I thought maybe you were looking for a cab.
Where are you calling from?
This is Horse Cars in Raleigh.
In Dallas. Well, I'm in Aberdeen, so I would not be calling Dallas for a taxi.
I don't know. Maybe you're calling the wrong number. Anyway, goodbye.
Good evening, Skene House Road Mount.
Hello, taxi.
No, this is not a taxi service.
I'm Lynx Taxis.
Sorry?
No, you've just rung me.
I haven't just rung you.
Yeah, where are you, please?
Where am I? I'm in Aberdeen. Where are you?
Of course you haven't. Well, how have I rung you then?
I have no idea.
So how have I just picked up the phone and said, hello, taxi?
I have no idea. I did not call you. Where are you from?
How dare you keep accusing me of ringing you up when I'm clearly not?
Don't stand there and give me grief.
Oh,
hello, reception.
Hello.
Hello.
Have we been connected before?
I don't know who you are. I don't know why you're calling.
You've just rung me again.
I'm going to stop answering the phone to you because you are giving me too much grief down the phone.
I haven't dialed you. I'm sitting here by the fire watching the television.
And I'm sitting at work doing my work and you are interrupting me.
We can hear a call calling. Okay, we're not calling you.
Yes, because that's why. Because I work in a hotel. Because I work in a hotel. Obviously, you're going to hear the phone ringing.
Disturbing my evening as well.
Excuse me.
I am fed up having you say that. I'm fed up having you abusing me and calling me a liar. In effect, I have told you that I have not called you.
And I have not been calling you. Okay.
Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
I understand what you're saying, yes.
Do you understand the fact I've told you on numerous occasions I have not called you?
What is your name, please?
Hayden Spedding.
What is your name?
And who are you?
I'm not telling you my name.
Why?
Good evening, thank you for calling Water Beach Hotel. You speak with Perry, how may I help you?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
You've just called me. I've just picked up the telephone.
No, you've just called us.
This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere. You're calling me.
No. This is the Roslyn Beach Hotel in Southend. You've just called us through our hotel switchboard. It came through
no,
to reservations.
No, I haven't. This is the Brendan Chase
sorry?
In Windermere. I've just picked up the telephone. You've just called me.
No, I'm sorry, sir, but it seems to me that somebody's playing jokes with you because we have not made any phone calls. We've just answered the phone call.
Really?
So it sounds like somebody is playing jokes.
There's somebody playing a joke on us.
Same here, mate. I'm not being funny. This happens all the time. It's a company, and they've actually got something going on. They get two people to call. Both of us right now are paying for this call. If
really?
It rings again and it's an unknown number... Don't answer it, mate, honestly. I've only answered it to tell you, honestly, but don't answer unknown calls.
Yeah, but unfortunately, this is
a reception
at the hotel, and we have to answer the phone calls. We can't just ignore phone calls.
I know
we
you
have
haven't.
Answer this somebody
you,
is playing jokes.
You said, I don't understand English. I've been trying to explain to you. There's
no,
a company out there,
English,
yeah,
because I am English, thank
going,
you very much.
And both our phones have just rang. Now, when I answered it, you're on the end. You answered. When you answered your phone, I'm on the end. Both of us are paying for this phone call.
Yes, well, you're the one that phoned us, because I'm the one that answered the phone, because it came through as hotel reservations. So do
well,
you wish to make a reservation?
Stop calling me.
No? Okay, then. Thanks very much. Bye-bye.
I haven't called you at all.
Hello, how can I help?
God, not again. Can you get off the line, please?
Sorry?
You're obviously stupid, aren't you?
Sorry?
Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
Yeah, well, you've rung me. You don't have to be so rude.
Can you hear me clearly now?
Yes, I can hear you.
Are you stupid or something? I have not rung you.
You have rung me. How can you be so rude?
No, I haven't.
Hello, Jackie speaking. How can I help you?
Yeah, you've called me. I just picked up the telephone again, yeah.
I don't know. I've just picked up the phone.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but yeah, I've just picked up the telephone. My telephone had just rung and I picked it up.
Same here.
Really?
But I haven't called anybody.
Who am I speaking to?
Jackie at the Able Group.
My name is David Maloney.
Right. So have you booked an appointment with us?
No.
So I don't know what's happened there, as I say. My phone rang and I picked it up the same as what you're saying there.
I've just picked up the telephone and I've answered the telephone.
Same here, as I said.
Really?
I haven't rung you.
Well, my telephone has just rung and I've picked it up.
So have I. So I can't answer what's happened with the telephone.
You're obviously stupid, aren't you?
Really?
You are extremely rude.
Well, you've just called me stupid, so who's the rude one?
Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
Yes, and do you understand what I just replied with?
How dare you speak to me like that?
You've called me stupid. Do you think that's polite?
Are you stupid or something?
No,
I have not rung you.
Hello?
Yeah, you've called me. I just picked up the telephone again, yeah.
Yeah, I'm not speaking to you. You were so rude last time.
Who am I speaking to?
Green Taxis.
Right, I didn't get that. You broke up. Say it again.
Green Taxis.
You're breaking up, you fucking asshole. I can't understand you.
Hello?
No, I'm not. I'm in Cornwall, in United Kingdom.
Well, you're a bit far for us to pick you up. Cheers, now. Bye bye.
You're a fucking packy cunt.
Leaving Tarsis.
You got anything else you want to say to me, cunt face? Yeah, do you want to talk to your mum? I've got a lady right next to me, actually. I'll just stop her sex talk and she can say hello to you.
Sad life. What a sad life to lead.
I fucked them both.
Listen on the phone. Your hopes go
yeah, and that's a fact. I mean, I have fucked them both, but they're actually really crap, you know what I mean?
Blah, 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 blah.
You really are fucking sick, ain't you? Go on, cunt. Go for it, pesky cunt.
Get it right.
I would actually say all your religious colleagues are actually fucking arseholes as well. In fact, as far as Muslims are concerned, all Muslims
God,
are fucking gay.
What
a
sad life. What a sad life.
Floating
Nazi comes at this time of night just for a hoax call. What a sad existence.
You packy, packy, packy.
You've got it wrong, mate. You've got it wrong.
Go on, cunt. Go for it, packy cunt. Fucking your mother.
It's
great, son. She's a really good fuck.
Anyway.
You know that?
Cheers, mate. Bye-bye.
Fantastic. Best cocksucker I've ever fucking had, your mother.
Hello, Link Saxes.
Hello, sorry, Emily's Francis.
No, you've just rung me.
No, my phone's just rung. This is Inverness Taxis, though.
So how have I just picked up the phone and said hello, taxi?
And I've just done the same, though. It's come, I don't know what's been on because this is an Inverness Taxi company.
How dare you keep accusing me of ringing you up when I'm clearly not? So you thought you'd harass a woman?
No, nobody's harassing anybody. Sorry about this, but if you want phone management, between 9 o'clock and 5 o'clock. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Yeah, I really feel like... What?
Right. Hello. That's well into April.
I'm sorry?
Hello.
Hello?
Hello? What?
Hello?
Can you hear me clearly now?
I can hear you, yep.
I know you can hear me, and I can hear you, but who are you? Why are you calling me?
No, you've just called me, mate.
I just picked up the telephone, and I've answered the telephone.
Yeah, it should come up unknown, because you've just called me. So I'm being
really?
Called Imperial Plumbing. Would you have called me for any reason by accident?
This is Brendan chasing Windermere. I've just picked up the telephone, you've just called me.
No. Nah. You must have called me beforehand. I'm Ben from Imperial Plumbing.
No, I haven't. I have not made a telephone call all day.
Are you sure about that? Because
I'm
my fucking saying that you called me. Me, mate.
I have not made a telephone call.
Is this a wind-up? This has got
Sorry,
to be a wind-up, surely.
I'm asleep in bed. I'm asleep in bed and you've woken me up.
I have no way. I don't believe that.
What?
I don't believe
where
that.
Where are you based?
I'm based in Southend-on-Sea.
I live in Cumbria in the north of England.
Yeah. Oh, crikey.
Yes.
How come you phone me? I can't come out and service your boiler, I'm afraid.
Yeah, I'm sorry, but yeah, I've just picked up the telephone. My telephone had just rung and I picked it up.
That's weird, isn't it? Okay.
All right. Well, have we already spoken today?
Not to my knowledge, no. I mean, do you own property in Southend?
No.
Oh, right. So that's just weird, because honestly, I haven't phoned you. My phone just... I've just finished doing a park run, and my phone is in the van as we speak, and it's just started ringing, so I've just answered it. So that's really weird, isn't it? Okay, listen, mate, you go back to sleep. Enjoy your kit, all right?
Can I have a conversation with you?
Sorry?
I've had the phone ring here. I found that the people at the other end thought that I was calling them.
Yeah? That's weird.
They think I am calling them.
Don't worry, mate. I think you need to go back to sleep.
I've ended up speaking to people in Alaska, the east coast of the United States, and a variety of other places, but...
I need to contact your phone company who provides you your telephone service and have a little word with them, I think.
This has happened before, and I've contacted BT, but they're hopeless. They can't explain the situation at all.
Okay, right. Well, you get back to having a sleep, and have a nice day, all right?
Okay. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good morning. Pamcourt Hotel, Donald speaking. How can I help?
Hello.
Hey.
I didn't get that. You broke up. Say it again.
What was that, sorry?
Are you any idea where you're phoning?
We've not phoned anyone. It's the Pamcourt Hotel
me.
Here. There's no one phoned here as far as I'm aware.
Piss off and leave me alone.
Okay. I've certainly not called anyone in the last... Well, since I've come on shift. That was a couple of hours ago.
Both of us have rang, and what happens is, it's a company, I don't know how they're doing it, but they do it, and we both get directed through them, and I pay for the call because your phone rang and you answered it, so that makes, because I answered it, it means I've rang you and you've rang me, so we're both paying for this call. Why can't you fucking accept that?
I'm not actually sure how that's happened.
You really are fucking sick, ain't you? Yeah, well, you would have both been paying for that call. It's like, I'm not being funny, but we're both paying for this now.
So where is it you're calling from?
No, I'm not. I'm in Cornwall, in the United Kingdom.
Okay. Because this is the Pamcourt Hotel up in Aberdeen. Is that right, yeah?
I'm not being funny, yeah? I get them, and they go on to about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. I mean, some of them are really bad, and when you answer them, it's normally an American on the other end that's shouting and screaming and swearing at you because they've been getting them all the time as well.
Ah, okay. Well, I'm fairly certain the calls shouldn't be coming from this number.
I haven't gave you any information. I don't even know where you got my number from.
Yeah, because it wouldn't be us that's calling you, so I'm not sure...
Stop calling me!
...where the numbers come from. Have you stayed in the hotel before?
Fucking your mother is great fun. She's a really good fuck, you know that?
Okay, well, I'm just going to hang up there, so I'm really sorry.
Go on, cunt. Go for it, packy cunt. You're the best fucking packy cunt.
All right, I'm hanging up there. I'm sorry. Good morning, Pamcourt Hotel, Donald speaking. How can I help?
What the hell are you doing phoning me?
I'm not phoning anyone, sir. You're calling me.
Right, I'm reporting you now. I've had enough of this.
Because I'm not calling anyone. It's our phone here that's ringing.
Excuse me, I haven't called you once.
It.
My phone keeps ringing and you're on the fucking end of it.
Yeah, well, I appreciate that. It's the same thing that's happening with me here. Like, my phone just rang, so I just answered it.
I know
I've
you haven't.
Anyone.
This is what you said, I don't understand English. I've been trying to explain to you. There's a company out there, yeah, that have got a con going, and both our phones have just rang. Now, when I answered it, you're on the end. When you answered your phone, I'm on the end. Both of us are paying for this phone call.
Okay.
Packy shite.
Yeah. Well, I'm not... I'm actually Scottish, sir, so...
You packy,
I have no idea
packy,
where you're from, but...
Packy.
It could be, sir, but... It's definitely not me that's calling you.
Yeah, do you want to speak to your mother?
No, I'll be fine.
Well, do you want to speak to your sister?
Don't have a sister, no, sir, no.
In actual fact, mate, I fucked them both.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, in actual fact, I have fucked them both, but they're actually really crap, you know what I mean?
Okay, that's good.
Both look like pigs.
But, yeah,
they're really fucking ugly, just like you are. I must admit, I do enjoy fucking packies.
Okay, look, sir, seriously, I'm going to have to hang up now. Cause
you got anything else you want to say to me, cunt face?
Yeah, it's not me that's calling you, so I'm not sure. I'm just
right
answering the phone.
You carry on, go for it. Packy, shite.
Okay, right, I'm hanging up there.
You really are fucking sick, ain't you?
Right, well, look, Sir, I'm just answering my phone. It's not us that's calling you.
Yeah, well, you would have both been paying for that call. Like, I'm not being funny, but we're both paying for this now.
Yeah, I know you've said, but I'm not calling anyone. I'm just answering my phone.
I didn't get that. You broke up. Say it again.
Like, I've not called anyone. I just answered the phone, and it was you that was on the other end.
I can't understand you.
Yeah, I've not called anybody.
Stop this fucking bullshit.
Look, I'll leave the phone off the hook if you want.
Fuck off and leave me alone.
We've not actually called anyone from here, sir. It's only myself.
Ha, ha, ha. I'm a fucking packy. I've got no brains. Ha, ha, ha. Let's make phone calls and pretend we're really funny. Yeah, that's really good. Let's hide our numbers so we can't be traced. Well, hide fucking packy, cunt. You're being traced.
Okay, good. Trace it then. You'll see, this is a hotel. I've not called anyone from here, sir.
No, I'm fucking well not. Stop fucking phoning me or I'm going to bore you.
I've not been calling anyone, sir.
I haven't called you at all.
I've just answered my phone. I've not called anybody.
Get a fucking life, you stupid bitch.
Frankly, I'm just going to hang up.
I wouldn't do anything with it. I'm a millionaire. I don't need your fucking money.
Hello, Barbers.
Hello?
Hello? What can I do for you? You've just found us.
You've called me. I haven't called you.
This gentleman reckons we've just called him, Joe.
No,
I do apologise then, but it was ringing this end, mate.
Who am I speaking to?
You're speaking to the barber's friend, Reese is my name.
Whereabouts are you?
I'm at the Bell Barbers.
My name is David Maloney.
David Maloney.
I'm living in the Lake District in the United Kingdom.
Aren't you lucky? It's the sun shining, we've got rain.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm getting telephone calls, basically, from various places in the world, okay? I'm getting other people cutting into the telephone, into the call.
My suggestion to that, sir, would be phone your phone supplier and see if anybody's hacked in, because I can promise you the phone rang our end as well.
I've been in touch with the British Telecom Service, and they seem not to be able to do anything about it at all.
I'll change supplier then, because they should be able to find out who's tracing your calls.
In fact, you have just cut into a call, okay, between me and a gentleman in America.
Oh, well, like I said, our phone rang this end, so I do apologise for any inconvenience, but it's just as inconvenient for us because we're working in a barber's.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, I do apologise, but
in bed,
I would strongly suggest
that you...
The telephone
rang, and I picked up the telephone.
Maybe chuck out some stronger words to BT.
I've reported the problem to BT, I'm afraid, but they don't seem to be able to do anything about it.
No, I'd get onto the complaints department then.
I've no idea why it happens or how it happens.
No.
It's just a mystery.
I know, but I do apologise, but I promise you the phone rang this end, because we're not pranksters.
There's somebody playing a joke on us.
I think so. I do think so.
I picked up my telephone about 3 minutes ago, and I was talking to a gentleman in Oklahoma, in the United States.
Oh, yeah.
Where are you based?
In Essex.
This is Windermere.
We're in Essex.
I live in Cumbria in the north of England.
Oh, crikey.
That's unbelievable.
The north of England, he's saying that the phone's rung his end. We've phoned him, and somewhat it's been happening to him regular. I would strongly suggest just chuck out some big, strong words. Look through the... Well, I don't underestimate your knowledge, but chuck out some big, meaningful words at them, and I'm sure they will sort something out.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. But I must get on now. We've got a shop full.
My telephone... I've just been on another call to a relative of mine, and I heard another call coming in. I've cut my relative off, and I've just picked up the telephone to answer your call.
Yeah, don't cut off. If you're in a conversation with somebody you phone, don't ever hang them up to go on to one of them incoming calls. I'd advise against that. I might even join Sky TV.
Why?
Because I feel like I'm giving out some good advice.
Okay.
I'm afraid I can't help you, but... All right, but I must go now. I'm sorry for being rude. and I hope you sort your problems out soon.
I am sitting here, and I am getting my telephone is ringing, and I'm finding that I'm talking to people in America who think
we better get off costing you a fortune.
I've ended up speaking to people in Alaska, the east coast of the United States, and a variety of other places, but...
I'm sorry,
some sort of cross line or mix-up in the call.
Are you through to the Roslyn Beach Hotel? Levi speaking, how may I help?
Can you hear me?
Pardon, sir?
Can you hear me clearly now?
Yes, I can hear you, sir.
I know you can hear me, and I can hear you, but who are you? Why are you calling
me? We're not calling you. We keep receiving calls off of you, sir, and are simply answering the phone.
You've just called me. I've just picked up the telephone.
We have not called you, sir. We have got a ring on our phone. We have answered it every time, and it's you on the other end. So I don't know whether your phone is going off, but maybe I should suggest maybe turn off your phone, because I haven't got a clue.
No.
It's not us calling you, I assure you.
We don't do any telecalls
or anything like that. We're a hotel.
Telephone, and I can hear a call coming in. I've cut it off because I'm in business. And all of a sudden, you're on the other end of the line. I am not calling you. I have no idea what your telephone number is.
You shouting at me is not helping
ever.
The situation. We're not calling you, and you are not calling us. Then
you
the answer is not to answer the phone if it's ringing.
You are extremely rude.
Pardon?
Don't you understand English?
I understand, but you're now calling me names on the phone, sir.
We are not calling you, I assure you that. Filthy mouth. Have you heard what I've just told you?
You're saying that you're receiving a call and you simply answer it and we answer. But it's not us calling you, sir.
That's right.
I've heard what you're saying, but now you're calling us names. I haven't called you. Yes, that's what we keep receiving calls at reception in which we have to answer.
How many more times do I need to tell you, don't you understand English? I have not called you.
I understand English, sir.
And don't you use that language in front of me. How dare you?
Okay, so I'm going to have to hang up the phone now.
I can't understand you.
Good evening, Douglas Fidel.
Hello?
Hello, Douglas Fidel.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Can you hear me clearly now?
Yeah, I can hear you, yeah.
I know you can hear me, and I can hear you, but who are you? Why are you calling
me? Douglas Fidel.
We can hear a call, okay. We're not calling you.
You're not? Well, my switchboard's ringing, so...
I am picking up the telephone because my telephone is ringing.
I have no idea who you are.
I have no idea where you are, and I have not made a telephone call.
Yeah, well, not have I.
I know, but I've just been sitting here, and I'm not making any telephone calls.
Well, this phone just rang, and I just answered it, and I got you.
So I pick it up, and I've got you on the telephone. I'm sorry, but that's the fact, okay?
Okay. There's pretty much some problems.
I've just picked up my telephone. You're ringing me. This is the Brendan Chase.
I did not ring you. The phone just rang and I asked
you. I have never called you.
Good morning, Douglas Hotel. Can I help you?
Is this the chap that you've just rung me again?
Sorry?
You've just called me. I've just picked up the telephone.
No, so have I. I've just come behind the desk now. The telephone was ringing, so I've just picked it up.
I am not calling you.
Fair enough, sir, but I haven't been calling you. I know that.
You've called me. I just picked up the telephone again, yeah.
Well, something's wrong with the line, because I haven't dialed any numbers.
Who am I speaking to? Whereabouts are you?
Aberdeen.
Where are you calling from?
Douglas Hotel.
Where do you live?
I don't live here. No, this is the Douglas Hotel, Aberdeen.
My name is David Maloney.
Fine, but I haven't been trying to contact you, sir.
This is Windermere.
No ways have I been calling Windermere, no. I haven't called anybody all night.
I'm living in the Lake District in the United Kingdom.
Yeah, this is Aberdeen, Scotland.
Really?
Yeah, we must have a cross line somewhere, because nobody's been trying to call you, sir.
I can't believe it. I'm sorry, there's some sort of cross line or mix-up in the call. I've had a phone call this afternoon, and I picked the telephone, and I'm speaking to a lady in Cornwall, in the southern part of England, and now I'm getting a call from you.
Northern part. You certainly get around on the telephone.
Somebody has just rung me, and then rung somebody else.
Hello?
Christine Oswald.
Yeah. I can hear somebody in the background, a phone ringing in the background. Hello?
Sorry, we're not calling you. Yes, hello?
Hello?
We're not calling you. Where are you calling from, please?
I'm not calling from anybody. I'm just receiving a call.
It's definitely not us. We're busy here, please.
It's not us. I'm not calling you.
I'm not calling you. Well,
it'll sort itself out.
My telephone. You're
okay.
Ringing me. This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere.
Oh, yes, sir. I don't know what's happening. I was speaking to somebody else then.
You think I'm ringing you, don't you?
Well, our phone rang, so I don't assume you're ringing.
You have just cut into a call, okay, between me and a gentleman in America.
Well, I was speaking to you before, then I heard the phone ring, and then I just ended up speaking to this guy. Listen,
I've had the phone ring here. I found that the people at the other end thought that I was calling them.
Yeah, yeah. I got the same.
Well, I don't care, but I haven't rung you. I've never made an international call from here.
No, we haven't been calling you. There's a phone going again.
Is something wrong with the telephone system?
It must be. Must be, sir. OK, I'll put the phone down so you can take your call.
Hello, my hotel. Can I help you?
Hello, yes. Sorry, who is this?
This is an airport.
I've just picked up my telephone. You're ringing me. This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere.
Oh. I think someone, well, probably one of our guests has probably actually called. It's so when you phoned, you got the actual main switchboard. So I
really?
Don't know who had actually called you.
say that again, sorry?
I said most likely it would have been one of our guests, because if they rang from the room when you went to check who had actually called you, our actual main switchboard number would have came up. So when you called, then the call comes straight through to me.
Are you in the United States?
No, this is actually Scotland, Aberdeen.
You're in the United States, aren't you?
No, this is Aberdeen, Scotland.
This is Windermere.
That was in England, yeah.
I'm living in the Lake District in the United Kingdom.
Well, it sounds awful like as if someone who's staying in our hotel has called you.
Yes, exactly.
I haven't got a clue who that could be, because we don't have an actual call logger on my phone.
That's right.
Okay. I must apologise that you've been disturbed, but I don't know who's called you.
Can I have a conversation with you?
Yeah, if you want.
I'm getting telephone calls, basically, from various places in the world, okay?
Oh,
I'm getting other people cutting into the telephone, into the call.
Yeah, that's a strange one. Have you checked it with...
I've ended up speaking to people in Alaska, the east coast of the United States, and a variety of other places, but...
Oh, that's our call coming through.
Good morning, the Barclay. Mandy speaking.
Oh. I haven't dialed you. I'm sitting here by the fire watching the television.
I do apologise. My phone has just rung.
I'm sorry. There's some sort of crossed line or mix-up in the call.
Yeah, that call seemed to come through while we were speaking. That's why I actually put the phone down. I don't know how that could have happened.
It's just a mystery.
I think you'll need to call British Telecom and sort of report the fault.
I've been in touch with the British Telecom Service, and they seem not to be able to do anything about it at all.
Strange. Very strange.
It is very strange.
Because I was actually quite surprised that a telephone call came through.
Absolutely.
In the middle of us speaking, you know? And I thought, how has she also gone through with the call and speak to us from where in... It was like as if it was like an actual conference call. And that's not exactly possible unless you actually make the conference call up, you know?
It's unbelievable.
Like, technology.
I've no idea why it happens or how it happens.
No. Well, I'm an ex-actual British Telecom engineer from... Well, I actually left British Telecom in, like, 93.
Really?
So I'm just, like, confused as you.
Are you?
I used to deal with... like data sets, etc., at the end, again, lines for like betting shops and banks and all that, and
okay.
Like, lines for and that sort of thing. And it's the first time I've ever heard of this kind of sort of thing happening. Certainly, to me, it sounds like a fault with the actual telephone exchange itself.
I've had this problem for a long time, America and all over the place.
I've just been on another call to a relative of mine, and I heard another call coming in. I've cut my relative off, and I've just picked up the telephone to answer your call.
And that's the other special friend. Certainly, I didn't call, but if anyone else in the whole building had called, then I wouldn't have known.
It looks as though there's another call coming, cutting in.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Hope you managed to get your problem sorted. Bye.
Hello, can I help?
Hello?
Thank you for calling the holiday.
You are being transferred to
reservations. Thank you for calling Holiday Inn Southend. This is Katie speaking. How may I help you?
Can you hear me? Can you hear me clearly?
I can
now?
Hear you, sir.
This has happened to me twice.
Not very clearly. You do cut.
We've got problems here.
No, you keep
here.
Cutting out,
I've
sir.
I've had
sorry.
A series of strange phone calls today. Can I have your telephone number, please?
Of course you can. It's 01702.
Yes.
504.
Okay.
001.
Okay. Who am I speaking to?
All right.
Where are you calling from?
You're speaking to Katie at the Holiday Inn.
Where are you based?
Where am I calling from? We are on Southend-on-Sea, Essex.
This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere. I've just picked up the telephone. You've just called me.
No, we haven't called anyone, sir.
And who are you?
Who am I?
Yes.
I'm a receptionist at the Holiday Inn.
I've just picked up my telephone. You're ringing me. This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere.
No, I haven't rung you, sir. No.
Do you understand what I'm saying to you?
I haven't rung you.
You've just called
you're,
me. I
you're
just
saying
picked up the telephone.
To me that your phone rang and you answered the phone and we're on the other line.
That's right. I have no idea why.
You have no idea? Neither do I, sir. I have no idea. I haven't called you.
It is very
strange. The phone was ringing, so I answered, and then...
I've just been on another call to a relative of mine, and I heard another call coming in. I've cut my relative off, and I've just picked up the telephone to answer your call.
Same here, mate. I'm not being funny. This happens all the time. It's a company, and they've actually got something going on. They get two people to call. Both of us right now are paying for this call. If it rings again and it's an unknown number, don't answer it, mate. Honestly, I've only answered it to tell you, honestly, but don't answer unknown calls.
I'm sorry, but we have to answer every call, sir. We're a business. We can't be ignoring calls. So I'm sorry about whatever's happening with your end and your phone.
I don't know how they're doing it, but they do it.
That's whatever happening there, but no.
And I pay for the call because your phone rang and you answered it. So that means, because I answered it, it means I've rang you and you've rang me, so we're both paying for this call.
Right, okay. All right, yeah, no problem. That's fine. I'll keep that in mind for the future.
I'm not being funny, yeah? I get them and they go on to about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. I mean, some of them are really bad, and when you answer them, it's normally an American on the other end that's
shouting, screaming,
swearing
at you
because they've been
getting
them all the time as well.
If you're getting this all the time, then I would call up your phone provider because this is the first time I've ever experienced it, and I've worked in this hotel for many years and I've never had anybody say they've experienced what you've experienced, so I would call your telephone provider because that's not on.
I've been in touch with
but
the
of course if you think you're paying for this call then we
hello
sorry sir, you're cutting out. I can't quite make out your connection.
You're breaking up your fucking ass. I can't understand you.
Hello, ITV London.
Hello. Who am I speaking to?
To Jamie, ITV London.
My name is David Maloney.
Hi, David.
Where are you calling from?
You called me.
I haven't dialed you.
Well, my phone's just ringed and I've picked it up.
Really?
Yes.
You've just called me. I've just picked up the telephone.
No, I have done the same. I don't know what's happened there then.
Whereabouts are you?
Grazing Road.
This is the Brendan Chase in Windermere. I've just picked up the telephone and you've just called me.
Well, that's exactly the same as I've done, I'm afraid to say.
I haven't dialed you. I'm sitting here by the fire watching the television.
Well, I'm sat here on my computer doing my work, minding my business.
Have we been connected before?
No.
I'm in bed, actually. The telephone rang and I picked up the telephone.
Okay, well, I'm sorry about that, but it's definitely not myself.
Can I have a conversation with you?
You can do, but I'm very busy.
I'm getting telephone calls, basically, from various places in the world, okay?
Yeah.
I'm getting other people cutting into the telephone, into the call.
Yeah, you do know that it could be someone pranking you. There are some websites where you can put two numbers into, and you can then there's a third person who listens to the conversation at the other line. It sounds like something like that.
Unbelievable. There's somebody playing a joke on us.
Yep, clearly. If it's happening often to you, then that sounds like the outcome, and they're hearing everything you're saying now too, sir.
I'm not going to apologise to you. It is not my fault. I have not dialed your number. I have no idea who you are, and I don't want to speak to you.
Okay, no, that's fine. Thank you very much.
Well, I haven't rung you 50 times
yesterday. Have a great day, sir.
No, no, no. I'm...